We're actually getting a live shot right now. That is the ex-prisoner, Alan Gross, arriving just outside Washington. His first step on U.S. soil. I want to say this has to be, he was a prisoner for the last 5 years, is that right?
The last 5 years. And guys, another interesting component of what's going on right now on that plane. Alan Gross is the public face of what's happening today. But behind the scenes, there were more details to the swap here. There was a swap that Alan Gross was actually party to, but was not the center of. The U.S. is releasing three Cuban prisoners that were held, that were arrested and convicted for espionage a number of years ago. The swap is actually for a U.S. intelligence asset that has been held in Cuba for more than 20 years, according to U.S. officials.
One more time. So exactly the three people who were releasing, what exactly did they do?
They were convicted in U.S. court and held in the U.S. They were known as the Cuban Five. Two are already out. These are the other three. They were convicted for espionage activities in the United States. So we are sending those three individuals back to Cuba. But the swap, according to administration officials, is not for Alan Gross, who they don't view as an intelligence asset, so that wouldn't be a swappable individual. The swap is for an unnamed U.S. intelligence asset that's been held in Cuba behind bars for more than two decades. They say a number of major intelligence advances were made possible by before he was taken prisoner. So there's an interesting element. I think there's a lot more reporting on our end to do to figure out what the backstory is here. But I think what administration officials are trying to say right now is Alan Gross wasn't the prisoner swap. There's another intelligence asset that's the prisoner swap. Alan Gross was put in by Cuban officials, obviously, much to the joy of his family and a lot of lawmakers.